Operational report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Repairs impossible. Spotting report. Spotting report. Kill credit. Kill credit. Kill credit. Kill credit. Lost. Pilot killed. Pilot killed. Pilot killed. MIA. Pilot killed. Kill credit. Kill credit. MIA. 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 Kill credit. Killed. 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 Oh, dear God. Recon over Nagoya. Written off. Crash. Spotting report. Kill credit. Expansion. Promotions. Transfer. Collision check. No collisions this turn. Submarine check. No. Plice. Okay. He's got 16 points of damage. Sure. We're in no rush. Let's get him back someplace repaired and then come back to kill something. Billfish, Gabalan, Drum, Spadefish, Ronquil, and Picuda all being recalled to Kobe. Kobe, we have one submarine returned. Steelhead badly damaged. Let's make sure she's rearmed as well. Okay, we'll put her in. Oh, nice to have a big dry dock here. What if we go critical? Oh, critical? It actually takes longer? How the hell do you calculate that, jackass? 8 days, but critical takes 9. What about normal? Would it be, stupid beyond belief. 4 submarines. 1 for Shikoku. 1 for Nagoya. 3 for Chiba Station. We're quiet at Singapore. No more air attacks. But still loading up supplies. Okay, when they're loaded, they'll disband and we'll wait to sail. Legazpi, we have our AOs are still loading. Another group of transports has arrived. Oh, what the hell? What the hell, you stupid bastards? Ah. Okay, we're going to run for Kanoya. We're going to go up the same route. These guys are much faster, so we can catch them. We can catch them. Of course, we're going to have to burn up engine. Good grief, huh? Stupid. Just stupid. How'd I miss these guys? Okay, we're chasing. These are 17 speeds. These are 12 speeds. I think we should be okay. I think we should at least be able to catch them. Oh, to hell with it. Why burn it up? Let's just go on our own speed. If we catch them, we catch them. We have some spare escorts here. We're just going to go as we like. Yeah, if we catch them, we catch them. If we don't, well, we'll just be a day late. We should have enough I'm hoping we have enough escorts here. 4. How many is that? 51 aircraft? Well, it should be okay to keep the occasional spy plane off of us, but oh hell, it's just engine, right? Burn it. The carrier battle groups, I've just decided we're going to start sailing nice leisurely pace behind them and we'll catch them somewhere up here. So we're going to burn up the engines on the transport group, but that's right. How did I miss that? How the hell did I miss that coming in? Okay, tankers heading in to Manila. Manila, we're quiet. No ships damaged. We're still sending aircraft up to the front. Holy cow, we better rethink about. Let's take a moment. Before I send the aircraft up from Manila to Japan, we're quiet on Naha. I better figure out what we want to do. Let's take a look at the score. We've inflicted 160 losses, but we took 500 100. The enemy beat us 3-1. Beat our asses cleanly. Humiliating. The worst loss of the war so far. Let's see. Who cares what they lost? It's what we've lost. Look at that. 200 dive bombers. 400 dive bombers and torpedo bombers. Gone. Gone. For nothing. These guys got no hit. Virtually no hits. The heavy bombers did a little bit better, but if I didn't have the dive bombers acting as shields for the heavy bombers, would the heavy bombers have been massacred the same way? I don't know. Possibly. It wasn't as though the fighters didn't show up either. The fighters showed up. The fighters actually were here. 600, 700, 1,000 fighters were on the scene. And we got massacred. Are they too low? Is it at 13,000? No, well, no, they weren't too low. We flew them at higher altitudes. But the fighters got massacred too. So my original strategy was to use the Air Force to smash these units, because we've been doing it so successfully here at Wakayama. We did it up here, caught the enemy in the open, just blasted the living daylights out of them. Now that we are getting closer to Tokyo, we haven't bombed all that much, but we bombed in this direction, so this is further away from Tokyo. But as we got cold, now Tokyo is only 3 hexes away, 2, 3. If they're flying from Tokyo and this whole air defensive bubble here, if they can bring that many fighters to bear on Nagoya, and Nagoya doesn't seem to even have any aircraft on it. Well, it doesn't have the aircraft symbol, but it might be here. If Nagoya is going to be defended by a few thousand aircraft like this, we can't lose 400, we can't lose 500 bombers, 500 aircraft a day. We don't have enough. We don't have enough. Overall aircraft, we have 20,000 aircraft. Okay, everything. That's transports and everything. We take out the transports, we take out the patrol. We are left with 18,000. Take out the recon. 18,000 aircraft or so. We wouldn't last a month. We don't have the pilots. We don't have the planes to fight like this. So how do we bring the enemy to bear? How do we bring... The enemy has been trying to bomb us, and we've been killing him as he bombs our bases, and that's great. But I think the enemy's let up on us because a lot of his aircraft have switched over to... kamikaze, and the kamikazes do not work against land targets. So that's why the bombers, I think, have been reduced. So what the hell do I do? I'm thinking about moving over to Tsu and then bring the battleships up, and maybe we can bombard all day long here. That might have to be the deal. But I wanted to keep the aircraft. I wanted to use the aircraft to... I need Yokohama for her airfield, for her ports. I was going to bring the Air Force in close and then try to smash the units on here so that we can walk in with a bloodless victory. But if this is the kind of defense that we can expect out here, 3 hexes away, what's it going to be like when we're 1 hex away? And this is the only time I actually have to win the battle. I have to use the air. I need the air to win. And if I have to lose every single bomber getting it, then it's worthwhile. But bombing out here in Nagoya, bombing here, this stuff is nice, but we can win it from... Well, we're going to have to win it from the ground. So I think... that I gotta save the Air Force. We can't take 500 losses a day. Just can't. My Air Force is just shattered We'll take a look at the morale. Look at that. The morale, you get a 50% drop when you lose half your aircraft on a strike. These guys dropped four more than that. These guys started off with 36. They lost more than 50%. They had 36 plus 12 spares. 48 aircraft. We lost 75%. And it's just the pilots, too. The training pilots. And these guys don't even get any hits. It's the big boys that gets the hits, that deliver the kills. So I think I gotta change this. Okay. So we're not gonna bomb anymore. We're gonna hold off on the bombing. I'm gonna try some fighter sweeps. I'll see if we can engage the enemy with fighter sweeps if he's protecting. I'm not sure if the AI doesn't have combat air patrol directly over top of it. I don't know if the AI is gonna let me sweep his fighters. I gotta try something. The only real bombing mission I have to win is the one on Yokohama to smash his units here. Everything else we can try to win with. Well, we'll go after him with ground troops and possibly bombardment forces. But every other. This is the only one. So I'm going to save all the aircraft for this one. I have to win this one because I have to take the shipyards unscathed in order to run battleships into Tokyo. Holy cow. World just got a whole lot more difficult, didn't it? May 4th, and we have May, June, July, and August. 4 months. We have less than 4 months to accomplish all this. Okay, the fighters from Manila jumped as far as they could. I sent some to mostly to Kobe. They couldn't get any further than Kobe. Apari, we jumped the Indian Mustangs, also jumped over to Gifu. Naha, we sent the Spitfires here, Seafires, over to, I think it was Kobe. Yes, Kobe. Seafires, they're resting here. I'm trying to decide what to upgrade them. But right now we're just going to wait. We're hoping it stays quiet. We're leaving 60 fighters or so, approximately 60 fighters on Naha and on Nago. I'm hoping that'll be enough. We've got these night fighters transferring over to Gifu. Just sitting and resting. At Kanoya, our fighters are, these guys are rested. We're sending them on to Gifu as well. Nagasaki, I think I'm going to start pulling out these units right now. Some of them are ready to sweep, are already recovered. Now, I've had them here, and I don't use the base, but having them here might have prevented more attacks from Keijo and Korea. Just having a presence here, like the presence in Iwo Jima, just having a presence around here, I think prevented the enemy from launching more attacks on my convoys. But pulling them out may be like pulling the cork out of the tube, and they might attack more often down at Kanoya. But I guess I'm going to take that chance. I'm going to send the Delta Thunderbolts over to Gifu. All these other, the small stuff, the ones that are just learning, like ground units, I'll keep the Spitfires over here. Yeah, I'll keep the Spitfires over for Kanoya, because it's just a training base. I'll move these Mustangs over to Gifu as well. But I'll keep the ones that say ground, just training ground troops here, I'll keep them over Kanoya and Hiroshima. Up at the front, we are still moving across. Where's that reserve unit? Yeah, here we go. Okay, so two more days, and we should hopefully have reopened the supply lines. Still in the white. We're still in the white, not losing. No movement pips, thank goodness. These guys are moving to the east, trying to get around that, trying to get around Niigata. We took a hit here, and we have a 1-to-1 odd. I'm going to hit it again. I know. Look at the disruption. Look at that disruption. I know. But I think we might be able to get away with another reduction. If I can reduce it another level, it might just very well be worth the extra damage we're going to take. Okay, after being slaughtered over here, we're standing down. Everybody's standing down. Everybody. Rest. Everybody. Okay? All level bombers, all torpedo bombers. We're gathering. Re-adding the people. Oh, I guess I better start putting all these into the same command. What I'll do is, they're all under different bomber commands and whatnot. This might be why they're scattering. I don't know. I'm going to put them all under the 7th Air Force. 7th Air Force is under Pacific Ocean Areas. Where is it? 7th Air Force. And all the bases are under 7th, are all under Pacific Ocean Area. So I think I'm going to order all these aircraft under the 7th Air Force. Just something, it's easy to remember, I think. Fighter-wise, we're all these fighters that were on escort. we're going to load them back up pilots, planes, and rest and recover. My worry is by hitting the Goya every so often, every time we walk out of here, the AI gets a chance to recover his squads as well. Now, I'm keeping pressure on him just because I have the units I have enemy in the hex, so hopefully he doesn't recover as quickly. But the fact is, every time I walk out, the artillery, there's no way the artillery can keep enough pressure on the disruption and disruption and fatigue high enough or make it worthwhile. So every time I walk out, the AI gets a chance to recover. Now, if I move battleships over, I think I could, this is a level 9 base, I could move a few hundred fighters over to Tsu, and then we have a base here and just bombard from here. Problem is, the problem with that plan is it's within kamikaze range up here. And if we get hit with a kamikaze, there's no way to repair it. There's no shipyard here that can easily repair a battleship. So then I'd have to run the risk of trying to get it back around here, back to Kobe. A damaged ship going 1, 2, 3, 4. Is this a recipe for disaster? I don't know. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off here. We've already have a base force here. I'm going to order this base force to go active so we have radar coverage. I'm going to bring a few hundred fighters over here, and then we're going to put up some PT boats. Maybe we can draw the enemy to attack the PT boats, and we can slaughter them again like the way we used to. I'll give it a turn for us to rest, and then I'll try that next turn. But the battleships are here. We could use them. I just don't think that might be the only way to keep the base suppressed while my guys march out, recover, and come back. Otherwise, the AI might be getting just too damn strong for us. Over in the Bonin Islands, here comes that, what? A gift horse walking my way? We're moving to the east. Of course, we're going to call up a surface combat group, and I'm going to send the short-range Frobisher, Tromp, anybody else who might have short-range. Yeah, we'll give these guys a little workout. Why is Fox short on fuel? I don't know. Okay, so we'll send 8. Sure, we'll send 8. We have aircraft, we have cover, we have heavy guns. Let's go get them. Going to the east, huh? From here, and then Let's try here, in case we miss them. In case we miss them. Otherwise, we're quiet. Convoys moving back and forth. Quiet in the Marianas. More convoys still loading at San Francisco. Night contact. We ram into the ships with a heavy cruiser. Sink every single one of them. Night raid on Gifu. 22 Surugi. 4 shot down. Holy cow, no air raids in the morning or afternoon. I guess both sides are kind of spent. Woo! Oh. Bombardment attack, Nagoya. That's a pretty moderate Japanese casualties. Light Allied casualties. Bombardment, Nagano. No Allied casualties. Here is our deliberate attack, Nagoya. Right on! Fortifications reduced again. 1-to-1 odds. 5,000 casualties, but we took some pretty heavy hits ourselves. I think it's time to leave to rest and recuperate.